Hey everybody, welcome back to my channel. So my name is Mel, if you do not know who I am. I am an over the road truck driver. I am 23 years old and I got my CDL when I was 22. So I am coming up on 1 year of truck driving. I am teamed and yes. So this is gonna be a informational video or informative video of everything that you can do before you go to CDL school. So if you are still smoking on that ganja and you're not supposed to be, you have 180 days with all of these informational facts right here before you go to school and have to take the drug test and the hair follicle test, okay? So even though you shouldn't be doing that stuff, obviously life happens and sometimes people have to have those days to, you know, get that out of their system. So this is, you know, 30 days for the urine test and the hair follicle test goes back 90 days. So just to let you know, this is also for people who are not ready to, you know, get into that step fully. And this is also for people who have kids and they're trying to, like, you know, get their situation together, or just if you're having life happening and you're trying to figure out what you're gonna do about your job, okay? So let's get started. By the way, my co-driver is at the P.O. Box right now, so if you guys are wondering where he's at, he went and took an Uber to the P.O. Box, so yes. Okay, anyways, let's start. Okay, so there's gonna be like very few things, because there's only a couple of things that you need to do before your CDL school. It is very complex though. I know that some people are gonna comment below and say, you know, your school pays for all that stuff, so why are you doing it before? But honestly, this helped me out drastically when I went to CDL school. Like, more than anything I could have asked for, doing these steps right here helped me out the most. So let's get into it, okay? I have a whole notebook full of stuff that you need to do. Okay, so there's about three main steps, but I'm gonna go through all of them complexly, whatever it's called. Okay. So the first step that you're going to take is going to get a physical done. It is a DOT physical / medical card that you absolutely have to drive trucks. And the reason that it is the first step, because the second step, you have to have the first step done to be able to do the second step, if that makes sense. A DOT physical is basically the same thing as if you were playing sports in high school. You just go get a physical done. It's literally the exact same thing, just for a commercial driver's license is what you need it for. And so it consists of a urine test. It is not a drug test. I promise you, it is not a drug test. Don't be scared when they ask you to go pee in a cup, because it's not a drug test. It's basically to check things in your urine for any infections or something like that. So what they check for is, I wrote a list of things: general appearance, eyes, ears, mouth, throat, heart, lungs, chest, back, and spine. They do a blood pressure cuff on you and a vision test. So those are the things that you're gonna probably see whenever you go down there. So you can actually just search on Google DOT physicals, and it will pop up in Google anywhere around you. I did mine in Austin, Texas. As you guys know, I'm from Texas. I was in Austin at the time. So I literally just walked in and asked for one. You can make an appointment if you would like to, but me personally, I just walked in because I had no idea what I was doing. And that cost me about anywhere from $65 to $80, okay? Like I said, your school will pay for that if you decide to go through it with them. But honestly, having this done before I went to school was really nice, because when I went to go see the recruiter, when I first went to CDL school to apply, she asked me, do I have any of these things? And I had all of these things. So it was really nice. And it got me into school way faster. Okay, so the second step is going to include of why I said that you need to get your physical first. So the second step is gonna be for preparing for your permit test. Okay, so your commercial driver's license permit. Your commercial driver's license handbook, okay? This is going to prepare you to take your permit test. Permit is the same thing as having a permit before you have a regular license in the real world, okay? So, you know, like when you're 16 and you go get a permit at the DMV and you have to wait a couple of days before you can go take your license test, that is what I'm talking about. So back in the day, you were able to go get a permit test done and then take your license straight at the DMV. If you had your own truck, you could run it up there and go take a test. They have changed the law now where you do have to go to CDL school officially. There's no ifs, ands, or buts. You have to go to school to get your driver's license, your commercial driver's license, okay? So you're gonna go ahead and get your commercial driver's license handbook. So you can get this handbook at a local driver's license office, or you can look it up on Google or YouTube. I personally didn't know they had an actual handbook when I started. Nobody told me anything about anything. I didn't know anything about CDL or driving trucks. I'd only been in the world driving a car for 4 years, from when I was 18 till when I was 22, when I got my CDL. I did all of this on my own. I had no idea what I was doing, okay? But it all worked out. So me personally, I use YouTube because I'm young and YouTube was everything for everything, you know? TikTok is now everything for everything, but Yes, I went on YouTube and I looked up the entire manual for the commercial driver's license handbook for Texas, because that's where I'm out of. And so what I did was I went to go see what categories I needed to study for what was going to be on the test for the permit. So this is the most important part of the video. You need to know three categories before you go take your permit test at the DMV. One extra one, which makes four for Texas. So three of them for all the other states, which are general knowledge, combination, and air brakes. With Texas, you have to know general knowledge, combination, air brakes, and Texas regulations, okay? So before I went to the DMV, I had no idea how to take Texas regulations because nobody told me, right? And so I went in there and I took my test and I still passed my Texas regulations, but honestly, if I would have studied it, it probably would have been a better score. But yes, I still did pass. Okay. So most of the time, everybody usually fails air brakes because it is the hardest test. Personally, for me, I think that because I failed air brakes. But okay, so what you're going to do is you're going to go ahead and get all that stuff ready. So, right, you're going to be looking at the manual for your commercial driver's license handbook. You're going to be just skimming over the three categories that you need to learn before you go take your permit. But the most important part is what you need to do is download the CDL Prep app. It's a blue app and it has a steering wheel outline in it. It's like a white steering wheel outline. It is the best word for word to study when you're going to go get your permit at the DMV. I promise you that it is word for word at the DMV. I passed with flying colors. I failed air brakes because I wasn't really studying as hard as I should have been. It took me about a week and a half to study the entire thing. I literally just took tests over and over and over and over. Handbook for the commercial driver's license is just to introduce you to CDL and make you like understand what, you know, this whole thing is going to be about and like the rules and regulations. But what you really need to download is the CDL Prep app, because that is going to be the first thing that is going to make you pass the permit test before you go to CDL school. Okay, so the application fee to go to the DMV and take a permit test is about $25 in Texas. So it's actually fairly cheap. You know, everybody should have about $25 to take this test. And the physical is in the higher numbers, where, you know, $65 to $80 is kind of a lot for people who, you know, are about to stop working and go to CDL school. So altogether, you should have about $100 before you start this entire process. That's literally all you're gonna need, is about $100. So the general knowledge is going to be about 50 questions. The combination test is gonna be about 20 questions. And the air brake test is gonna be about 30 questions. And if I didn't study and I passed, they're pretty easy, you know what I mean? So you do have three attempts to take these tests. If you do not pass them in three attempts, so you have three tests, or four if you're in Texas, if you don't pass them in three attempts, you have to restart the entire application process all over again. So what you need to do is make sure that you try your hardest to pass these, because restarting the entire thing means that even if you passed a couple of the tests the first time, you're restarting from the beginning, okay? So you have 180 days until this permit expires. I held mine for a long time. I held mine until the last day I had where it was gonna expire, and I was literally about to start CDL school like 2 weeks from that. So I want to tell you guys that this is a good time to make sure that you have everything in line, because I want to tell you guys that these are really good steps to take before going to CDL school, because you have 180 days before it expires. You have three attempts, so you have all those weeks in between, because you know it's hard to get a DMV appointment. It's so hard to schedule a DMV appointment. You know, they're weeks out at this point. They're always so hard to get. So, you know, you guys have really, really a lot of time to study to get your permit test and stuff like that. So just a breakdown of all of this. So number one is get your DOT physical medical card from a clinic near you. Have about $65 to $80 for that test. You will take a urine test. It does not matter because it is not a drug test, okay? The second thing is go get you a commercial driver's license handbook and just skim over it. It's good to have because it has little facts and information on it that you may need before you take your permit test, okay? And you can look that up on YouTube, Google, or you can go to your local DMV office, okay? And the third step is that you need to download CDL Prep app. You have to download it to pass this test, okay? If you cannot find the app, DM me on Instagram. I will help you out because I do not mind as long as you are taking the steps to do what you need to do. Just know you have 3 tests you need to pass, 4 if you're in Texas, and the application fee is about $25. You have 3 attempts and 180 days till it expires. After that step is done, and I'm so sorry I'm all over the place. I'm so bad at telling stories, even though I literally have it all written out right here. My handwriting was trash. But if you guys want an extra little pointer, I'll tell you guys what's the next step. I wasn't gonna add this in here, but you know what? I don't want people to just be hanging around. So my next video is going to be an in-depth video of what I'm about to talk about now. So what do you do next after you have your permit from the DMV? You should be completely free and clean. Your body and your system should be clean. I'm telling you now, do not go to CDL school playing around because you will fail your test and you will get kicked out of school and you will look crazy, okay? So the first thing you need to do is find a CDL school near you. This step is very hard for some people to understand. They don't understand how you find a CDL school. What you're gonna do is do not get into a contract with the company who is telling you that they'll pay for your CDL. I know many people do it and sometimes it works, but sometimes it does not and you are stuck in the contract for a year. And if you decide to break that contract before your contract is up, it's going on your credit, okay? Or you're gonna have to buy out of that contract. It's not a good thing. It could cost you so much. It can cost you thousands of dollars to get out of a contract, okay? Okay, so what you need to do is you need to go ahead and Google a CDL school near you. I personally went to Roadmasters Driver School. I loved it. I went to 2 locations for Roadmasters. I went to the Dallas location and I went to the San Antonio location. Me personally, I did not like the Dallas location. I thought the Dallas location did not have enough instructors. They were very short staffed and the school was entirely too big, way too big. So my co-driver was in San Antonio at the time about to start CDL school and I had ran down there with my car and we had just started CDL school together down there instead because I had all of this stuff done. So my recruiter was basically like, you have everything done. You can start at that school. It doesn't matter. We don't have to do a whole application process, right? That's why I tell you guys, if you ever decide to switch your mind last minute, get all this stuff done so that when it is time to start school, if you do hate that school, you can switch to another school because you already have all this stuff done. So the few things that you want to check before you go to a CDL school is call the school. They're not going to give you exact price points, probably not. But you can ask a few questions like, is it manual, like stick, or is it automatic? Me personally, I did not want to do anything with manual or stick, the same thing, but I didn't want to do anything that had to deal with stick shift, gears, clutches, none of that. I went to an automatic school, which is Roadmasters, and I loved my decision. So after that, you're going to go ahead and schedule an appointment with an advisor, and they're going to tell you to go ahead and come up there at an appointment time and date. So the main thing that you're probably wondering is how much does it cost to go to CDL school? All CDL schools are different. My school costs about $5,500 for Roadmasters, right? And then I had a $2,400 loan as well because I was living in Dallas at the time and I needed to go to San Antonio to go to school for 3.5 weeks, almost a whole month. So they actually put me in a hotel for 3.5 weeks for $2,400. And yes, you do get a roommate, but women are not usually in CDL school like the men are. So I didn't have a roommate for 3 weeks. I only had a roommate for like my last little week, you know? For like a half a week. It was so nice. My co-driver, he had a roommate and they got along so well. But anyways, that's beside the point. But yes, so you need to look at price points. When people tell you that you need to go to CDL school and you're like, I don't have the money for it, I promise you, you do not have to worry about it. If you go to Roadmasters, and I'm not sponsored by Roadmasters, I don't even know if that's a thing, but if you go to Roadmasters, they will put you on a loan. Yes, the interest rate is very high. But yes, you will be able to pay it off because guess what? The company that you choose to go with, they have a tuition reimbursement. So they give you about, you know, a couple hundred dollars every month to pay back your loan. So like, let's say that your school loan is $7,000, right? Your company that you decide to go with after CDL school is going to give you a certain amount of money. Let's say it's $200, right? And your loan payments every month are $190 and your company is giving you $200 to pay back your tuition reimbursement every month. So basically you're keeping some pocket change because this is only $190 and they're giving you $200 to pay it off. You keep about $10, right? Some companies pay more tuition reimbursement than others, and that's just a personal, you know, company by company basis. So don't get scared about that. But yes, you would not have the opportunity if you decide to go in a contract with a company. So do not do that if you do feel like you may not like the company that you're with. Me personally, I chose to use the GI Bill because my stepdad was very nice, and he gave me the GI Bill to pay for the CDL portion part of it. So the actual CDL school was paid by my stepdad, and the $2,400 for the hotel for 3.5 weeks was paid by a loan that I got, was given to me with a loan that Roadmasters gives you. By the way, this does not need a credit check. It doesn't go through anything with your credit unless you don't pay them afterwards, after all is said and done, right? But you have like a whole like 2 months to find a job after to even pay them back. So you're gonna be good. Don't worry about it. You do need money in CDL school though, because you need to eat. So the three steps that I did talk about previously, those are all steps that you have before you go to CDL school. The last step is just a bonus step, and you don't have to listen to me if you don't want to. I'm just telling you my experience. It worked out 100%. I love the way I went. I love the route I went. I think it was amazing and fast and awesome. I love CDL school. I freaking love being out here on the road. I love, love, love my career. And I think it was the best decision I've ever made in my life. I'm only 23 years old. I got my CDL when I was 22, and not to brag, but honestly. But yeah, so all of these steps worked out for me. So if you guys want a more in-depth video about how I paid for CDL school, even though I kind of gave you some facts about it, let me know and I will go through the entire thing with you guys. If you guys have any CDL questions, I will do a Q&A for my next video. It's about CDL school, CDL, over-the-road life, team life, any of that stuff, home time, all that stuff. Go ahead and comment below. I will do a full in-depth video for you guys with the Q&A. On my next video, I might even do it tomorrow if you guys are watching this fast enough, because your girl's off till Thursday. So anyway, thank you so much you guys for watching my channel, and I hope that you guys like, subscribe, and comment. And yeah, bye guys.